some folks it means something, and to some folks it don't. But one day you look for me and I'll be gone. So may the metaphors of my smile and the haikus of my heart say that if I pass on tools, then I'll be back by Wednesday. Change my name to Ocean, protect my love who's old goon. So keep a candle lit and incense and sage and shrines to the dying who brought you the lines and rhymes and rhapsody, and then some, and then some, and then some.
I've been living just enough for the city, so if I miss a step, I might meet my death. And the only thing that'll be left are these words that came through me. And I've been giving y'all reality without any degrees of separation, placing pieces of my soul on these CDs so that my death cannot erase them. And when I'm gone, I want you to begin my shrine with a fat jug of palm wine and a fifth of Glen Levitt to represent my grind, and the collected speeches of Malcolm X to represent my mind. And listen, don't even bother trying to find a coffin for me to fit in, cause I wanna be buried in the royal linen with my body tucked into the fetal position, so it'll be clear that I intend to be reborn for all those who might mourn my passing and recite my poems with passion and eulogize me in their own, and then plant me like a seed so the universe may breathe into what you have sown and recognize my existence in every instance that you hear my poems. And whether you smoke blacks or ales or guzzle H's or prefer herbal tea, incense or fragrance, whatever you do, just light a candle when you do it and recognize that the steam and the smoke be my soul's conduit, and my children be my life's monument, and tell them whenever I spit it wasn't never counterfeit, and make sure them rookie poets genuflect whenever they hear the name Taalam Acey. Respect.
Red carpets rolled out, and if my burial were a concert, it'd be sold out. My casket so old, the grass growed out. And the epitaph reads, here smiled Moses' prodigal child. Bury me in style, wearing the clothes I'm wearing now. Bury me with my face facing the ground so I can speak directly to my ancestors for a while. And I don't need any cheers, just need someone of many years to stand and say his last words went this way. Life be about travels and trials, and mine was about kicking the gravel and putting in miles. Keep walking. After my burial, let the poets begin talking and have the artist Azakwe begin chalking an outline around the last pen I ever wrote with. Then give this pen its own funeral and my favorite lines to quote with pass to the astronauts so they can staple them to the sun and moon. And that way, even if my life was done too soon, every day my words could still shine. For those blind, put my words to music and ask Bocelli to use it. Then give a version to B.B. King so we can blues it. Then a version to Coltrane so we can reduce it to just instrument. For those whose relationship with me was so intimate, maybe you could use it to heal your soul's pain, or at least freeze it within a frame until it's a story of fame on the nightly news, or maybe just Acey's cold blues. Take the shoes off my feet, mail them to my girl so she could know what it felt like to walk around in my world, and ship my body 2,000 miles away wrapped inside of 2,000 of my poems I never got to say. And if I die with the next day, have all the children that were ever outcast gather around to play with these words, or have them chirp by mockingbird. If I die within the next second, have Taalam interject until his voice mixed with my thoughts carry the same effect. I will genuflect. Respect.
Most High Jim. Yeah, I just dropped it. And then some. And then some. And then some.